welcome. Now, I think we've all looked in the mirror at some time and thought, hey, I wouldn't mind shedding a few pounds. Yeah?
Yes.
But what happens when that thought turns into an obsession? How far would you go to get the perfect body? We're going to meet somebody who took drastic measures to lose half her body weight. But is she happy now? To find out, please welcome Mick. So, Mick, tell us, what did Leslie look like when you first met her?
She was big, bouncy and bubbly. She was about 22, 23 stone. But she was a fun person.
Fun person. Now, how long ago was that?
10 or 11 years ago.
And what's she like today?
She's about half the size she was then.
Yeah.
But through the weight loss that she's endured,
yeah,
she's lost her personality.
So when you compare the two women, the Leslie you met 10 or 11 years ago to the Leslie you've got now,
yeah,
personality-wise, who would you rather have?
The one she was.
The one she was?
The one she was.
So you say she lost her personality when?
When she lost the weight, which happened very rapidly because it was through surgery that she lost it. She lost all her confidence.
Yeah.
She lost... I wouldn't say she lost the will to live, but she certainly lost all her vitality and a sparkle.
And what's she like to live with these days?
She's been through a lot of depression. She's just not the fun person that I knew and still love.
Yeah.
But I want the old wife back.
When she was 25 stones?
Not the size, the personality.
The personality. How much
the size, I don't mind. I'm quite happy if she was back the size she was.
Doesn't bother you?
Any difference.
So what does she weigh now?
I think she's around about 12, 13 stone, something like that.
So she's half?
About half her. Half there's another one of her out there somewhere.
Is that how you feel?
Yeah, yeah. And the half that's out there is the interesting, the fun, the bubbly half.
So what would you like to happen now?
For her, she needs to be the size that she is. I think she's happier with that from a physical viewpoint. But from an emotional viewpoint, to get her confidence back somehow and to get to be bubbly and lively again as she always was.
Now, you actually split up for a while, didn't you?
We did, yes.
Tell us about that.
We were apart for 4 years.
Yeah.
And for the first three and a half of years of that, we used to see each other through work.
Right.
And then just about 3 years ago, I saw her. She'd had the operation about 3 months previously.
So she had the operation while you were apart?
That's right, and I knew nothing about it.
What did you think when you saw her?
I thought she looked great.
But what did you think about her personality, who she was? Did you start seeing a change even then?
She was different. She was certainly different.
So what do you want to say to her today?
Well, she has actually put some weight back on since then. She went through the manic exercising, so on and so forth.
The exercise?
Yeah.
How long for? What we're talking about?
Oh, for months.
But, I mean, how long was each exercise session?
Well, like 6 hours a day.
Six hours a day exercising?
Yeah, she'd go to the gym. She'd drop our daughter off at school at 9 o'clock in the morning, go to the gym and come back in time to pick her up at 3:30.
So what do you want to say to her today?
She's stopped doing that now.
Yeah.
What I want to say to her is I want her back the way she was 10 years ago. Well, even 7 years ago.
OK. All right. Well, let's meet her. Please welcome Leslie. Go ahead.
So, basically, I want you back as the person you were, personality-wise. I mean, I love you very much, you know that. Always have done. You've lost your personality when you lost your weight. I want that personality to come back. You to be the same bubbly, bouncy, fun person that you were when we first met.
It's not quite that easy, though. It's confidence, it's... I just can't do it.
So, Leslie, what's the problem? Because most women would say if you'd gone from 25 stone to, what, 10 or something like that, most women would say, wow, fantastic.
Yes, but at 25 stone, I was solid.
Yeah.
Yeah, solid. Quite confident. Nothing stopped me.
Yeah.
But as I lost the weight so quickly, I'm left with a lot of loose skin, which I was under the impression was going to be dealt with. they dealt with my stomach after. And
as far as an operation's concerned?
As far as an operation's concerned. But my legs particularly really bother me. Everything is featured on my legs. I think everybody's looking at my legs. I've got a lot of loose skin from the knees up, and it's very saggy. And it moves. As I move, it moves. I'm aware it's there all the time. I feel clothes don't fit me. I feel totally uncomfortable about it, and I feel as if everybody's looking at it.
And what about what you used to do? We were hearing that you used to be in the gym for 6 hours.
I used to drop Sammy off to school and go, because I wanted to get rid of the... I kept thinking that if I went to the gym or watched my eating, I went through obsessions, that it would actually get rid of the skin, but it won't. They've told me that the skin is there. I can get rid of the fat, which is gone,
but
I'm still left with the very loose skin.
So are you saying now that you've stopped all of that?
No.
You haven't? What are you doing now?
I go through obsessions.
Like what?
I've gone through obsessions where for 2-3 months all I'd eat was soup. I went through the obsessions of going to the gym permanently. I've taken laxatives, which Mick doesn't realise I still do.
You don't know? You're saying he doesn't?
No.
You didn't know that?
I thought you'd stopped.
No, I still take them.
What else?
I still go to the, again, he asked me to stop going to the gym. He is very supportive, but he asked me to stop going to the gym. But I do sometimes still go when he doesn't know I'm going, because it's there. My legs are there. They're always there.
Mick, you didn't know that?
No, I thought that had all stopped.
Because he did say before she'd stopped going to the gym.
Yes.
So what, you're doing it behind his back now?
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Not as much as I was, but...
How do you feel about that?
Well, I just worry that it'll get back to the same obsession that it was before. Well, you might be going, I don't know, are you going once a week, twice a week?
Once a week.
For a couple of hours?
Once a week, yeah.
For how long?
Is it going to escalate back to the sort of every day, all day?
So what are you doing now when you go to the gym?
It just depends. Some weeks I'll go all the time, but I also went through a phase where I wouldn't get out of bed.
Okay.
I got out, took my daughter to school, and then I went back to bed and stayed in bed.
Gosh, stand up for me.
Can I ask what operation you had anyway and why you had it?
I had stomach bypass, and they took a third of my bowel away. They said because of my weight, eventually it would cause damage to my health, so they suggested I had it.
Yeah. So the operation was a success, it's just what's happened to you since?
The surgeons say that, there last week, the surgeons say the operation was a big success.
Yeah.
But they only look at the physical side, they don't look at the mental side.
So what do you want to say to Mick today then?
Well, I want to thank him for all his support, and basically if you can just be more sort of tolerant. We have a problem sometimes if we go out for a meal. I can be sometimes physically sick because I can't eat much. And if we go out and
You can't eat much?
That's right.
How much can you eat in one go?
Probably just maybe a starter. But you see, it's in my mind that I can. So I might go to a restaurant with Mick and I'll order a meal, and he's shaking his head and he'll say, well, you won't eat that, and I think I will. Then the meal comes and I might have a forkful and I physically cannot eat anymore, which he does actually get a bit annoyed about. Help that.
Well, I don't really see the point. I mean, I thought that had been cured. I know in the early days when we were first back together that was a particular problem. Excuse me, and I got used to that and came to terms with it. And we'd go out and Leslie'd perhaps order two starters rather than a starter and a main course.
But now you have to sit there.
And she was okay with that.
Yeah.
But I thought that problem, because she was very, very skinny then, a lot smaller than she is now, and I thought that problem had disappeared.
Can you tell Leslie what she was like in the old days when you first met her compared to now?
Well, she was great. I mean, I'm fairly big myself, obviously. And we just used to walk into a room and everyone knew us.
Yeah.
We were pretty famous around Leeds. Being in the licence trade obviously
helped. Yeah.
And you were so bubbly and full of yourself, full of confidence. And that's what you've got to try and get back. I know it's difficult, but there's got to be a way of doing it.
You think it's all down to this skin?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Stand up for me.
Thanks. Before you had the operation, did you not think that
afterwards, after losing all the weight, that would make you feel a bit better? You know, I mean, psychologically, you're saying you feel better without the weight, but did you not prepare yourself to think that maybe, yeah, I'm going to lose all this weight, I can get into all these clothes, it's going to make me feel better?
At first.
Rather than the reverse.
Yeah, well, so. At first it was sort of quite novel, losing the weight, because you could actually go into any shops and buy clothes. But I lost myself. I was walking past a mirror and I'd have to double take and walk back because it wasn't me. I feel as if I've lost me.
You really feel like you've lost you?
I'm in here somewhere.
So what would happen if you put the weight back on? Would you feel better then?
Probably.
Right, now, we've met this lady before. Stand up for us. Now, this is Joy, and I don't know if anybody here can remember her, but in case you can't, this is when she last appeared on the show. Are you saying that this stomach stapling is your only option? I mean, some people are going to say, why not diet? I mean, you're going to hear that.
Well, I've been all down those roads.
You've tried it?
And tried and tried.
What about some people say having their jaw wired?
I've had that done when I was 16.
Did it work?
No.
Now, that was you how many weeks ago? Not that many weeks ago.
No, 14.
Yes, yeah. 14 weeks ago. Mm. And what happened?
I had the gastro bypass and the stapling.
You went ahead with it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Had it the 1st of February. I was 27 stone. Now I'm 19. It's the best thing I ever did. But there is no support psychologically about really for people who've had this done. We've set up a support group. After the show, if you'd like to speak to me,
you set up
we'll
a support group. Because
yes,
let's just have a look at you back then, and that's you. Yes, you have lost a lot. Mm. Very, very quickly. Have you noticed your personality changing?
Yes, for the better. I've got more bubbly.
For the better?
Because I wouldn't go out, I wouldn't do nothing, but now I'm more outgoing and want to do things.
But how are you going to feel if you get this same issue with the loose skin?
Well, this is the problem, but with the support group, we can all support each other and help each other and find a way to work around it all.
You think talking to other people
yes.
about it?
Because I understand exactly how you feel, because I felt the same. But I think with support of other people who's been through it, know exactly how you're feeling, and we've all tried different ways to get round it and sort things out. Because I'm going on holiday in a fortnight, because I want to be 7 stone by February next year.
Seven stone?
I'm only 5 foot, so okay. The surgeon said. But as soon as I get to a size 10, I'll be happy. So I'm going to buy some clothes ready. But I'm determined I'm going to get there. And if I can help anybody else with the same problem as me, who's had this done, I'd love to. Or anybody overweight. You know, if we can help, we will.
Does that interest you?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Well done. But in the meantime, what are you going to do?
As I am now.
Well, what about this relationship? What are you going to do?
Well, I'm just going to have to work at it and try between us.
I'll have to try and be a bit more understanding. But I mean, it's this lady saying here, sorry, I don't know your name.
Joy.
There are people out there perhaps we can talk to. Not just you, but us
together.
As a couple.
Yeah, let me just quickly come back to
you. The support group is for both partners because the husbands have problems as well as us women who's had the operation, you know, have come into terms with the different, you know, because obviously your personality and that changes.
Well, maybe you'd like to all get together after the show and sit down and start talking.
Yes.
Because life does go on. You've got to do something else. You don't want to... I mean, wouldn't it be sad if in a few years' time or whenever it is, you actually have the operation, get all the skin removed, you turn around and everybody's so fed up with you. Then you turn around and you say, hey, look, don't I look great? And there's nothing coming back.
No, it won't go that far.
It won't go that far. You split up once, you won't split up again.
No, definitely not.
Well, you've got a love there that needs, like any plant, it needs watering and cherishing, doesn't it? I must say, I do feel, though, whatever surgeons can do with knives, ultimately, I know it sounds corny, but it's how we feel about ourselves. And I think we've got to keep working on that all the time. All the time. You never stop working on yourself. Yeah? Mm. Well, good luck. Get together with Joy and have a chat after the show. Well, coming up, meet the woman who says her friend absolutely must lose weight before it's too late.
You're always criticising me. You know, just because I'm a big girl, I think you're jealous of me. That's the problem.
Jealous?
Why do so many slim women want silicone? These are all mine, look!
No. Stay with us. Have you had enough of being told what to do? Maybe you think it's time your partner stopped bossing you around. Perhaps your relationship's in difficulties because your in-laws just won't keep their noses out of your business and you want to tell them enough's enough. Maybe your parents still treat you like a kid. Or perhaps your siblings think they know it all and are always there to say, I told you so. Well, if this sounds like you or someone you know, call me on 0900 911 1199. That's Trisha, 0900 911 1199, or email me, trisha@angliatv.com. Noticed, summer is on the way and we're all starting to worry about how we look in swimsuits and bikinis and what have you. Well, meet Dorothy. She says her friend has got to lose weight or face the consequences. So, hi Dorothy. So Dorothy, describe Jane for us. What does she look like?
Jane hasn't got much height and she's very fat. I think she's too fat. She still is a lot of weight. Mm. And I'm always at her, nagging her, telling her to lose some weight, you know, because she's a very nice person.
Yeah.
And it will make her more attractive, you know.
You want her to lose weight so she looks better? Is that the only reason?
Yes, look better and feel better in herself. Because she's a bit too, you know, it takes away her energy and everything and make her breathless. And
now, how old is she?
I really never ask her age, you know, Jo.
She's about half your age.
Yes.
You don't mind me revealing your age. You're 70. We can share that. They won't tell everyone. But, I mean, seriously, do you feel you've got more energy than she has?
I do. I feel that I've got much more energy than her. Because if we are walking together, yeah. I'm way in front of her and she's behind me. I've got to turn back and ask if she's all right. You know? Are you all right there, Jay? Yes, come on then. And she's, you know, she's trying to come breathless.
Yeah. So what's she eating that gives her this weight problem?
She eats a lot. I think she eats a lot. This morning, she had about three rolls and croissants. I said to her, I said, Jay, how many croissants did you have? One. I said, how many rolls? She said, two. And then she ordered toast and everything.
Did she have breakfast?
She had a big breakfast. She was only having a small plate, but a full one, you know, that like a mountain.
So do you nag her when she does that?
Yeah.
What do you have for breakfast? Or what do you think she should be having for breakfast? Fruit or something like that?
She should have some fruit juice, a salad and marmalade or something like that. Toast and marmalade, you know?
Yeah.
But this morning she had egg, bacon, sausage,
you know,
everything, and the plate was about that size.
Oh, well, now, what about exercise? Is she one to walk places?
She would rather take the bus than walk.
Every time?
Yes. And we only walk about 10 minutes walk from where we are to our home.
Yeah.
And she has to take the bus.
So you think, obviously she's got
to... We could walk it.
You could walk
it. But she'd rather take the bus.
So she wouldn't go to the gym or do exercise or anything
well,
like that?
Well, we have made arrangement now to go to the gym. And we'll start...
You're going to go to the gym?
Yes, I've made arrangement with her to go to the gym because I think she needs a little exercise.
And you're willing to put a leotard on to get your friend into the gym?
Oh, yes, I'm going to put my leotard on and do some exercise too because I've got to encourage her.
A friend you're concerned about?
I'm very concerned about her. She's a very nice friend. Mm. But then, you know, she needs a little more exercise.
But does she agree with you when you tell her all of this stuff?
One minute she'll agree and the next minute she'll say, I like it. So, I don't know.
So what are you going to say to her today?
Well, I'm going to tell her that she has got to lose a little more weight. Mm. I said to her last night, I said, do you think you should lose about 2 stone? She said, I would like to lose about 3. I said, well, there you are. If you want to lose 3 stone, you've got to work at it. Another time she'll say to me, I'm all right and I like it. I like the way I am, you know? So, I mean, maybe she don't know what to do.
Okay, well, let's meet her. Please welcome Jay.
Hey, Dorothy.
Jay, you heard what Dorothy had to say?
I did hear what Dorothy said. I think the problem lies with Dorothy.
Why? You tell her, you tell her.
Dorothy, you're always criticising me. You know, just because I'm a big girl, I think you're jealous of me. That's the problem.
Jealous?
So, why do so many slim women want silicone? These are all mine, look! You
know? Janet, I'm not jealous of you.
But I think you are.
You need to lose a little more weight. And you do agree sometimes, you agree. And another time, you disagree.
Well, I think if you weren't so aggressive with it and be more encouraging with your nicer, compassionate comments, then I'll take on board.
Well, I encourage you to go to the gym.
Yeah, I do go to the gym. I think you should go to the gym.
Well, I said we'll go together, don't we?
Yeah, I don't mind. Well, if you can put your leotard on.
I will, certainly will.
Oh, well, I'll put mine on.
We've got our photos of this when it happens. But seriously, what about this not keeping up? Because we were hearing from Dorothy before, when you're walking, you're dragging your heels.
Dorothy over-exaggerates. Well, you can imagine, I've got 3 flights of stairs to run up to college, you know?
Well, she came into college the other morning.
You're at college too?
Yeah.
We're both in the same class.
Yeah. She came into college the other night.
Yeah.
All breathless. John, what happened to you? What? Why are you out of breath? Mm. Oh, I had come up all those tears. I said, well, girl, you need exercise.
Well, I was getting me exercise, wasn't I? I had those loads of tears.
You should have heard her breathing away in my back.
What did you do? I was doing the aerobics. What else?
So tell me, Jay, have you always been this size?
Well, I was slim in my teenage year, but I wasn't happy. I had to be bulimic, to be awake, because other people's idea of notion of big. Big is beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
Big is beautiful. But
if you lose a little more weight, you'll be more active.
I think you need to keep your mouth zipped up.
But, Jay, did people treat you differently when you were slimmer?
Well, I do find that younger men is the problem, European men.
Why?
I find that they're a bit more judgmental. They don't mind seeing me in the night time, having a bit of hanky-panky with me, you know.
What do you mean? Hang on, say this. Did I miss something there? What are you saying? What is it with the younger guys?
I find that European men tend to be a bit more judgmental than African men and Mediterranean men. They got this. I think it's the whole European culture of the notion of what is a normal size.
So they think that you're overweight or you're too big. Let me put it in a nice way. They think you're too much of a handful.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
But what was this hanky-panky bit?
Oh, well, they like hanky-panky, you know, like having the fun bit, you know, in the dark, you know, see me in the dark, but not outside, take wine and dine in me.
Oh, I see.
So if there's any nice, creative, professional men out there who want to wine and dine me, I'm available.
Right, they've all gone very quiet. So what about the health aspect, though?
Well, I do agree that I feel if I was put myself at risk, I would do something about it. I mean, I'd like to lose a little bit, but not, like, be half the size, you know?
So, Dorothy, how much do you think she should lose?
I said to her last night we should like to lose about 2 stones. She suggested 3. So?
I mean, it's only because I'm going on a holiday, you know. So you want to put your shorts on, have a good time, isn't it? That's why.
Yes, then.
At the end of the day, you're a lovely lady. You know, you should lose it for yourself, nobody else.
That's right.
I think it's people like you have got the problem. I don't have a problem with me. I think it's other people putting their
problems on me. You don't think you've got any health concerns?
Well, I'm not saying that I shouldn't go. I mean, I used to go down the gym and that. I feel that if you exercise and you keep your balanced and that's fine. But I think that you can go down the street, whatever your shape and size, and get knocked down. We take silly things for granted.
At the end of the day, if you're happy with yourself, just stay the way you are. You're a lovely looking lady. It doesn't matter what everybody else thinks of you, as long as you're happy.
I know.
Okay.
This is
okay.
I think it's about you.
Well, but then what about the health concerns? Come on, let's...
Well, I mean, I used to go down the gym.
Hearing about what you used to do, but if you're getting puffed out, and we're hearing from a lady who's twice your age that you can't keep up with her.
This is because I'm late for class. I'm running up the stairs. I'm doing my exercise on the stairs, aren't I?
But what about this taking a bus everywhere?
Bus everywhere? We walk sometimes.
Dorothy obviously doesn't agree.
I don't agree. I think Janet should use a little more
weight.
Well,
I've got something I want to say to you. I've written a poem. Is that okay, Trish?
Yeah,
just read that poem to Dorothy.
I don't know what I'm setting myself up for, but go ahead. Yeah.
I know there's a lot of me. As a result, you won't let me be. You don't give your mouth a rest, even though I'm trying my best. You won't budge. You act as if you're a judge. But don't you see I'm proud of me? So stop pestering me and leave me be. I'm not harming you, and no matter what I do, you carry on. Sometimes I wish you'd be gone.
Oh! Dorothy?
Well, I don't... I still think, Jan, that you should lose a little weight, and I'll still keep on at you, and I want you to go and lose a little more weight.
I find that is hurtful, Dorothy. It's the way you come across as very aggressive. If you were soft and gentle and encouraging, perhaps I'd probably take
on
board.
So how should she say all of this, then?
Yeah, but it's very aggressive, you know, more gentle. It's the way she comes out in class sometimes on the bus stop and other people are around. It's really embarrassing.
And says what?
You know,
in the
bus stop, you know, you're out of breath, your chest and your heart and this and that, and you're too fat, you know?
Okay, yes.
She probably, you've got a good friend there. She probably do come across aggressive, but she's only thinking of you. You are a lovely person. You are, you're very pleasant to look at, but she is a very good friend. And the last line in that poem was not called for. That was not called for at all because she's thinking of you and you only. And to say in that last line of the poem, wish she was gone, you won't get a better friend than her.
Oh, that's in the class and at the bus stop. I don't mind, we, you know, but that's just in class and where her mouth is too loud.
Yeah, but she is concerned and she's a good friend.
Thank you. Sounds a bit like a mother-daughter relationship that you two have got going, yes.
Just a little tip for Jan. If she's trying to attract creative professional men,
right,
then I think she should adjust her clothing. I don't think that is going to attract the right sort of man.
So what should she be wearing?
Well, a creative professional man would not go out with a lady in that skirt, for instance.
Let's see the skirt again.
The split skirt.
Okay.
Okay. So you're saying the clothing's wrong. Oh, you poor thing. Yes, sorry.
Sorry, Trisha. I used to worry about my weight quite a lot.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I do worry about my weight, but I used to be anorexic when I was a teenager, when I used to do some modelling for a newspaper. And I've gradually put on all the weight over the years, and I'm not particularly happy with myself now, but my husband actually loves me the way I am, and he says I'm so much of a nicer person now, and I'm so much more outgoing now.
Okay.
And everyone likes me for my size. I do worry inwardly about it.
But people still like
people
you?
People like me as I am.
Okay. Thank you. What about partners? What about...
I think that's
what about a man in your life? Do you have one?
No, because they can't measure up to me.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you know, I don't want any old couch potato. I want somebody who loves fun, who likes eating, doing, enjoying life, being.
Eating? Yes. Well, that came pretty high up in your priorities. What about dating agencies and things like that?
I did join a dating agency for large women. But you find that...
For large women?
Yeah. But it wasn't very good.
Why not?
They tended to have more women on the books.
Okay, and how did you describe yourself in the small print?
Well, she said that I was mixed, attractive, bubbly, outgoing, you know.
You didn't meet any guys through that?
I did meet men, but I think they were just like messing about. I didn't meet, you know, really decent ones.
Yeah, decent ones. Yes.
I think if you're happy and comfortable in the clothes that you're wearing, you should wear them.
Oh, thank you, love. You're a sister.
You are a lovely person, as I can tell, but does it actually get you deep down? Because it's like, I don't know how to put it.
Do you think some people put on a bit of a front?
Yeah, it's like a front.
Yeah. I think it's when Dorothy and other people, friends that make comments,
do you count
that
as
hurts.
Bullying? Because that's what I count as, Dorothy
Thank
bullying
you. Brother. That's right, it is bullying.
No. But hang on, let's start off with the first bit of this young man's question. Dorothy, you said yes. You think deep down she might not feel so good about it. Thank
no,
you.
No, deep down she don't feel so good about
it. Actually, you're not me, are you, Dorothy?
But you always say that you haven't got a mate and this. And if you lose more weight, then you'd be more attractive
Have
to
you
people.
Seen her when she's down about her weight, then?
Is no, I've never seen her.
Down or upset about it?
No, she don't seem quite upset about it. She thinks she's feeling good that way.
Okay.
She looks good that way.
All right, stand up for me. Now, yes.
Yeah, I was just wondering to know, have you ever thought going to a slimming class of some sort?
I did join them, you know.
No chance?
Yeah. You did. And you
I
lost,
did, yeah.
We've got a picture of how you used to look.
Yeah.
And that should be coming up in a minute. And this is you, that's you then. How much did you weigh then?
27 and a half stone.
How long ago was that?
Well, it's 1998, February 98.
And how much did you lose?
13 stone.
13 stone. Yeah. How long did it take you to do that?
Yeah. Just on 12 months.
12 months, 12 so months, like yeah. Just over a stone a month?
Yeah, just nearly there.
So
yeah.
What advice would you would you give today?
Well, I can only say what went through my mind at the same time. People used to say to me, I mean, the first thing that used to do with me, I used to crack jokes about myself. Because I was a more or less bubbly person like yourself are, you know. Mm. But and then you get the little jibes in the background, people calling you fat and different names. You just call me Steve Davis. Because I wouldn't leave the table till it was cleared, you know. And food was a
big... But did it hurt deep down?
Well, I used to crack the jokes first so that I get them in first so that it didn't really hurt. And only close friends, like you've got a very close friend there. We're thinking about your own personal, you know, the way you are.
Yeah.
They're not really worried how you look, but it's how you feel, and she's probably trying to help you. I had a lot of friends that used to try and help me, you know what I mean? But
do you wish you'd listened to them, or was it when you
decided? I wish I'd listened to them a lot earlier.
Okay,
you know
thank
what I mean?
You.
It did, it did work out, yeah.
Thanks, Bob.
As regards to that man, I mean, I do understand what people are saying to me, but at the end of the day, nobody's going to force me to lose weight. I'm going to do it for myself and not for nobody else.
Yeah.
It's got to come from you, because if you try and do it for other people, you just put it back on anyway.
But are you a healthy eater? Do you think you're a healthy eater?
Sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not.
You've got have you got a penchant for what, chocolate or something?
I tend to like Chinese. Chips, sorry.
Chinese and chips?
Yeah.
Together?
No.
Okay. Do you think she's a healthy eater, Dorothy?
I think she's
you haven't even seen me eat, Dorothy.
Well, there you are. I haven't seen you eat. This morning, what did you have?
Yeah, but you're exaggerating, Dorothy. I didn't eat. I had a small plate.
Oh, pile up.
It wasn't piled up. It was just a small chitty plate. What do you think? I had a piece of bacon.
She took a side plate and she put all what was on the table in it.
No, it wasn't, Dorothy. I had a small plate. You had the big plate and I had a little tiny titchy plate. I made sure I had a titchy plate because I knew you were going to be with me eating, watching me eat.
Yes, Joy, what are you going to say? Stand up for me.
Do you think that being your friend's trying to bully you into it, that's making you eat more because you're thinking, blow you?
Yeah.
And you do it. But if you want to really lose weight, you've got to want it from your heart and do it for yourself.
That's what I was saying.
The more people bully you into do it, the less likely you are to do it.
Yeah, it's got to come from you, as I stated before.
Thank you. Thanks. So, what should Dorothy do? Okay, you tell Dorothy. What do you think she should do to be a more supportive friend?
Well, I think you should lay off, basically, and just give your mouth a rest, as I said in my poem.
Well, Janet, I think you still need to lose a little weight.
She's not going to change.
Janet, you should try and lose a little more weight.
I think you're just jealous, Dorothy, because you want to wear nice, sexy clothes and you can't. And you want to have nice, big boobs like me.
So, well, Jay, I guess if you decide, as you say, if you decide you want to lose weight, then I guess you'll do something about it. But I think, you know, Dorothy probably has got your best interests at heart, really.
Mm-hmm. Jay will do something about it. She's going to go to gym. And we'll go
so
together.
So are you going to go?
I will go with her.
I hope you will keep to your promise.
Are you both going? Seriously, are you both going to go to the
gym? Yeah, I'm going to go to the gym, go to water aerobics.
Yes.
You will do that?
Yes.
Well, it sounds like she's starting to listen to you, so maybe you could just back off a little bit, Dorothy.
All right.
Oh, good.
You will?
Yes, well, I'll back off a little and give her a chance to show me what she's going to do. And then
sounds
I'll see the result. I will see the result.
Yeah?
another story when we get to class.
Okay. Send us the photo of you two ready to go to gym.
Yes,
certainly.
All right. Good luck. All right, there's no such thing as being fat and sexy, so says this guest.
I just personally don't feel sexy or nice. I think I'm fat. I know I'm fat.
So you think if you're fat, you can't be sexy?
Yeah.
Is she right? Stay with us. What I want to ask is, how do you deal with a friend when all they do is moan on and on about their size? I'm sure we've all had a friend like that at some stage. Yeah. Some of us have. I think Dave has, so please welcome Dave. So, Dave, what do you want to say to Tasha today?
What I'd like to say to her is actually to, if she wants to lose weight, do it for herself and not for the reason she's doing it.
What are the reasons she's doing it?
I feel from the way she talks to me and everything, she's got this idea of these, you know, you go out to a nightclub and you meet these hunks that are brainless and drink lager. That's my opinion.
What, if she lost the weight, she'd meet
these... Yeah, she would find an ideal man. Okay. Whereas she feels at the moment, you know what I mean, she could only sort of really, no one would look at her. So I just feel that what she's doing is, the reason she wants to do it is because she's got this conception in her mind of this sort of big hunk
so
of man.
So lose the weight, get the hunk.
Yeah.
Now you've known her for how many years?
I've known her as a teenager. I've got to know her properly over the last couple of years because she's actually moved through and I've been friend of the family for...
Right. So about what, 14?
About 10 years.
10 years, so yeah. About 10 years. Okay, so you're saying she's doing it for the wrong reasons. Yeah. Now, has she always been a bigger girl?
No, she was at 16. She was very slim. She started putting weight on around about 16.
Right.
And gradually, it built. I don't actually think she's that big.
You don't think she's that big?
I think she's actually quite a sexy girl. I think she needs to.
You think she's a sexy girl?
I do. Yeah, I do. I think you will do when.
But she obviously doesn't feel.
She obviously doesn't. No.
So you think she's trying to change the way she looks to get these guys? Now,
I think
she was
I
right.
I think she wants a secure relationship with the kind of man that she's attracted to. And the reason that she, the whole motive for losing weight, I think is to get that, rather than doing it for herself.
Right.
I think what she's to do, if she did it for herself, then hopefully she'll meet one.
Now, have you told her this?
I've quite nagged her, actually.
You've nagged her about it. What does she say when you tell her this?
She's got his front on, where she... You know what I mean?
But have you ever told her, hey, as far as you're concerned, you think she looks fine?
Yeah.
Doesn't take that on board?
She sort of shrugs, doesn't she?
Do you think she wears the right clothes to show, you know, make the best of herself?
No, she wears all these tracksuits and baggy stuff. I mean, she went out the other night, because often she comes and sort of says, you know, do you think I look all right?
Yeah.
She went out the other night with some friends, and she actually had a black outfit on.
Yeah.
That is a black silky top.
Yeah.
And slacks and sort of high shoes. But she actually looked really nice, but it was a tighter fitting than what she normally wore. And I thought she looked absolutely brilliant.
And you told her?
Yeah.
Had no effect?
Can't believe you.
So has it changed her personality, putting on this weight, do you think?
Yeah, she's put on a half front. I mean, she puts on a half front and says, well, yeah, I'm okay. But underneath, she really wants to lose it. I think she needs to realise why she wants to lose it. It's like she goes to a nightclub.
Yeah.
You get, I mean, no disrespect to anyone here, but you get lads that go, they think, well, you know, I'm going to pull tonight. They don't pull, so they look around, single mum. Bit overweight, so they go first. She's got to fight them off. That's the sort of person, yeah. So then she comes home.
And she's what, all upset?
Out. Yeah, well, I think they call it comfort eating, don't they?
So you think when she's, you're saying when
she's... When she gets depressed about it, she'll binge
out. She eats more?
Yeah, and like if the ice cream, there's like the ice, every time the ice, I mean, I'm always teasing her, because every time the ice cream man comes, she's straight out the door and down to the ice cream man. So it's just quite a funny thing.
Okay, so today you want to tell her what exactly? Not to go for the ice cream man or not to go for the hunts and the disco or what?
Well, both really. I mean, if you're going to lose weight, if you want to lose weight, lose it for yourself, yeah, and lose it for yourself for the right reasons.
Well, let's meet her. Please welcome Tasha. What did that smile mean, Tasha?
Bit nervous.
Nervous? Well, yeah. What do you think of what Dave had to say?
Oh, I don't know. I'm doing it for me, not for anyone else. I feel as though
I wouldn't agree with her.
What, you tell it.
I don't agree with her, you see, because the way you talk, like you think, like, you've got this idea of a sort of an ideal fella. I know you want a steady relationship, yeah. But you've just got it in your head that this is the type of fancy, and unless I lose the weight, that's what comes across when you talk to me.
Is that true?
I don't know. I suppose it's a little bit like that, but I want to lose weight for me because I'm not happy. I don't think I can be sexy.
Yeah, but why aren't you happy? Are you not happy because you don't think you're going to get this sort of ideal sort of what you want?
Is that true? You're out looking for these hunks, these words?
Well, I won't say she's out looking for it. I have to get
well, you know, in a nightclub, she wants... Yeah, you want the hunks to be attracted to you.
Yeah.
Well...
You've got your ideal man that you fancy, haven't you?
Yeah, but I just personally don't feel sexy or nice. I think I'm fat. I know I'm fat.
So you think if you're fat, you can't be sexy?
Yeah.
So fat women can't be sexy?
That's in my opinion, yeah. I don't think
Fat women can't be sexy. Oh, hang on, whoopsie.
Oh, you have to look at me, you know I'm sexy.
Do you think she's sexy looking?
I think she is.
You think she is?
Yeah.
What about you, Tasha? Be honest.
No, but that's my personal opinion. But I've spoken to Janet. She's happy with the way she is. So she radiates that outside. I'm not happy with the way I am, so I can't...
You can't give
put
off
it across to everyone else that I'm happy being
me. Can I give you like a whole lot of bunch of confidence? I'll work on you.
How? I mean, stand up for us again. So, what hints would you give?
Because I'll come and groom her, show her to do her hair and makeup and that.
Would that help?
I'll tell her how lovely she is.
No, it wouldn't help.
All the confidence, but I'll say the right words.
Oh no, hang on, just a minute. Okay, this lady thinks that she's got the...
She's going to groom her!
Stand up!
Yes, I think you would look a little bit better if you lost a little bit of weight. Do it properly. Most of us have been there and done it. It's great fun, the clubs, losing weight in a group.
Hang on, come over here.
But are you with the Conservative Party? I'm sure you've...
This ain't about politics, fatty. I lost the weight. I was grotesque as a child. I can equate happiness with slimness. For me, overweight means unhappy, depressed, hating myself.
Yeah. I think you are unhappy now.
No sex drive. Just crying at home on your own while you open another packet of hobnobs. I know. Lose the weight, darling. Do it properly.
Hang on.
You're unhappy.
What, you're saying what?
There's no wonder with that attitude. No wonder she's having a mad box. She can't have big boobs like me, that's what it is. She can't.
Okay. I'd rather boil my face in hot oil than have like yours.
Can we pay all that money, all these superstars, all these pay all that bunch of silicones?
Great if you lost 3 or 4 stone.
I think you look great if you kept your mouth quiet.
What do you want to say? Sorry.
This shows. We're talking about this young lady. Yeah. You said to her about changing her hair. Her hair is fine.
It's beautiful.
Grooming, her hair looks lovely. She looks lovely. And if she's out to get the ideal partner...
Yeah, what should she do?
The ideal partner, keep as you are. Because a man will be for you, not the size you are.
I'm not.
Okay, let me come to this lady. Yes, stand up for me. Yeah.
I think you're the one with the problem because she's better looking than you.
Oh no, she's not.
Feel, Tasha, let's not lose sight. How do you feel? Listen, people might disagree with this lady up here with blonde hair, but that might be how you feel. Is what she said ringing true for you?
There's a misconception. I'm not doing it to get a partner.
Sorry, let's hear it. Yeah, go on.
There's a misconception here. I'm not doing it to get a partner.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, do you feel like the lady said that fat is unhappy?
Yeah, definitely.
So, hang on just a minute. All right. I haven't got the mic on you two ladies, just hold on a second. Sitting here, looking out here, who do you wish? Is there a young lady in the audience that you look at her figure and you think, that's how I'd like to look? I could find me a man if I look like what? Our audience is that sad, huh? is there a figure? We're talking about figures here.
Yeah, that lady in the red top over there.
Where's the lady in the red top at the back? With the blonde hair?
Yeah.
Could you stand up for us, madam? So to you, this is the ideal figure? No?
No.
Sorry. Okay.
Sorry.
All right, okay. So, stand up for me. Yeah.
You
say can't be fat and sexy.
You can't be fat. That is rubbish. I mean, when Leslie was 26 stone, she was sex on legs, believe me. So what you're saying there is totally untrue. I think you look absolutely great. You've got a lovely face. I mean, I wouldn't say you were fat anyway, not compared to what I was used to seeing.
I'm not doing this to find a man. I'm not happy.
Can I let me clarify?
No, all the time I'm not happy, I'm not going to find a person. Until I'm happy, I'm not going to find anyone.
That's true.
Yeah, okay. I accept what you say there. What I'm saying, if you really want to, I mean, you do want to find a relationship. You want a steady relationship. We talked about it, you know.
Yeah, but I'd like to lose weight as well.
The reason I make the judgment of that you have this concept in your mind,
of the hunt,
is when we talked about, or like when we all live in a cul-de-sac.
Yeah, and you talk about this relationship things. Is that what comes up her weight?
It comes up where you think, oh, he's all right. She will say, oh, he's all right.
Yeah.
And then someone may be on a larger size.
You think the guys don't go for the bigger ladies?
I do.
I'm talking to Tasha.
In my personal
opinion. So you can't be fat and sexy. Well, here's
That's me. That,
I know. You feel you can't
I'm
be.
Unhappy and that lady with my weight. I'm unhappy with my weight.
You're unhappy with how you are. Okay, so if you can't be fat and sexy, before we take this argument any further, I'd like you to meet our next guest. Please welcome Ali. Hi, Ali. Tasha reckons you, well, for her, she couldn't be fat and sexy. What do you feel about that?
It's a matter of opinion.
Well, what do you feel?
I don't think that's true. I feel brilliant. I'm so happy. I'm more happy now than I've ever been.
And what do you do? Tell us what you do.
Various things. I work in the fat industry in London. In the fat industry.
The fat industry?
That's what we call it. The scene. There is quite a big one.
A fat scene?
Yeah. It's a fetish.
A fetish?
Yeah.
Fat is a fetish.
So is.
Meaning what?
Well, have you not heard of chubby chasers?
No.
No, okay, right.
Neither she, so don't look, you know, what a chubby chase.
Well, they're men that openly admit that they prefer bigger women.
Right.
They don't like skinny women, they love bigger women.
So there are clubs?
There are clubs, there are organisations, there are magazines, there's contests.
And you work in one of these?
I work in a club and I run, well, I'm an art director for a magazine.
But what do you do at this club then?
I'm a hostess.
Do you have to wear certain clothes or something?
It's a theme of kittens, cuddly kittens.
So what, you dress up as a kitten?
Yeah, it's a bit like the Playboy Club, but in kitten gear. So we've got fishnets and leotards and little
sexy
collars
gear.
And ears. Yeah, very provocative.
So is there a size, what? I suppose it must be the other way around. Have you got to be over a certain size?
Yeah, like 20 plus at least, really.
So would Tasha get in?
Yeah, she would get in.
And she would have to wear a kitten costume?
No, only if you work there.
Oh, if you work there. This is new to me. Did any of you know about this place?
Dreaming, I wouldn't even go there.
Huh?
I go.
You go? So what do you want to say to Tasha then?
I want to say that...
You tell her.
Okay. We've discussed how you don't find fat women sexy at all and they can't be sexy.
Yeah.
So in that way, I'd be quite offended because you'd probably be calling me unattractive then.
No, but then I said that's
that's your opinion.
But I said if you feel happy with the way you are, then you radiate that happiness. I don't feel happy with the way I am.
So how you feel affects how someone calls you attractive, whether they're attractive or not?
Well, I suppose that's what I'm saying.
Okay, so if you were thin, would you more attractive? Would you feel more attractive, and therefore?
Yeah, definitely, 100%. I used to be thin.
Okay, would that then mean that you might find fat people attractive because you'd be able to relate to them? Oh yeah, they're so happy, and you know.
So let me ask you, Ali. Would you feel more attractive if you were thin?
I've been thin. It really, my size has made no difference to my life till I made it make a difference.
Hmm. But is there a way this is interesting, is there a way, do you think, when you see bigger women, is there something in the way they hold themselves, the way they walk, that
definitely
makes you think they've got a problem with their weight?
I wouldn't go to the club unless I worked there,
mm.
Do you know what I mean? Because I can meet people walking down the street,
yeah,
and they're not chubby chasers, they're normal people.
Yeah.
And they like you because of your personality. They can read your body language. If you're feeling down, if you're feeling horrible, if you hate yourself, if you have an argument with someone,
yeah,
people can read that just by the way you're walking.
And the way you sit and the way you talk.
Completely.
So is there a way that you walk that you think tells people, hey, I'm proud of who I am? Is there a way, I mean, when you walk through the door, for instance, is there a way of holding yourself?
I think you do it naturally. If you're feeling good, you walk. You want everyone else to feel good. And it's so much, I mean, in London, if I go down, if I'm having a good day,
yeah,
I will get smiles, I get talked to, I'll get asked out. If I'm having a bad day and I'll be looking down, No one will talk to me, and you can see it from one day to
the next. So what about that, Tasha? And Dave's nodding as well. What about that? Yes, stand up for me.
Yeah, I mean, I was a lot slimmer, but I mean, I couldn't enjoy myself. I felt unhappy.
Yeah, but that's you. I feel happier when I'm slim.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean because you're slimmer or fat or whatever, you can't attract a man.
Yeah, but I'm happy when I'm slim. You're happy the size you are now. That's your prerogative. That's,
the thing
you know.
I find difficult, though, listening to Tasha.
Yeah.
And I don't want to cause offence.
Yeah.
Like, she keeps saying, I'm not happy.
Yeah.
But then if you're not happy, then you need to do something about it.
I'm doing something about it.
What are you doing?
But what happens is, if you get depressed or you get down, then you'll go and you'll pig out or something. Or you'll nitpick. Or you eat wrong. So,
okay,
therefore, it's defeating what you're trying to do.
Let me come back to Ali. Now, how do you feel about this lady here? I mean, there's some differences of opinion going on here.
Okay. From what I had, like, one thing stuck in mind. It said, fat equals unhappiness. Is that to you?
That's personal, having been fat. I was downright miserable. And it's a great advantage for you, body aside, that from the neck up, you're gorgeous. But for me, I would be unhappy with the neck down if that... I'm the same as you.
Yeah.
Do it for me. Do it until you feel, yes, in front of the mirror, yes, I can slide into this little pair of jeans, and yes, I can wear a swimsuit now.
But you don't think Ali's gorgeous? Well, I think
they're both. Yes, I think she's gorgeous.
Okay.
I think the package of that girl is superb. You know, she looks overall like a lovely ripe fruit.
Thank you.
Doesn't she?
Thank you
very much. Oh, thank you. Well, overripe fruit on the stage. Yes, stand up for me.
I just want to say that beauty comes from inside, and all the women here may be using their fat as an issue when it really is from inside.
Very good point. Is it? Tashmeet, be honest. Could it be that? Could it be that? Because there might just be a chance. Okay, so if you were slim, what would happen?
I'd be happy.
Yeah, why would you be happy?
I'd be able to wear the clothes that slim girls wear.
Yeah. And?
I'd have more confidence when I'm slim.
Yeah.
I'd be able to run about after my little boy. I've got asthma, and I feel that my weight affects my asthma.
That is a medical fact. It would be affecting your asthma.
Yeah.
What about on the relationship side? Would it make any difference? Come on, be honest.
I'd have more confidence, so maybe I would attract more people.
So what are you going to do? Has anything you've heard today make you think, well, there's something else I can be doing here?
I'm under the doctor at the moment. I'm on a diet. I've been on it for 2 months. I've lost 9 pounds. I'm a very impatient person. I want it today.
Yeah.
I don't
but you know what? The slower it comes off, the better.
That, yeah.
I know, but you still want it tomorrow. What about exercise? Are you doing any?
Yeah, I do sit-ups every night.
Listen, I've said about it before, and every time I say this, everybody writes in and says, what's the miracle cure? There is no miracle cure, is there?
I mean, wanting to do it.
It's wanting to do it. It's also about, I am a solid believer in exercise, such as walking. You got a little boy?
Yeah, I walk a lot with my little boy.
Yeah? How's your little boy?
It's 2 next month.
2, in a stroller and just get out there and walking. It's going to come off, it's going to come off. You know it's going to happen, but...
Yeah, but it's going to come off if she doesn't do the binging.
Yeah, well...
I don't binge.
Well, when you get upset, you do.
Yeah.
You go and eat and you eat a ghetto.
What about every time you get upset, you go for a walk?
4 o'clock in the morning, it's not.
Yeah, okay. All right, get that. But seriously, I mean, ultimately you've got to work on yourself because you don't want to arrive at that inverted commas ideal to find out that you've been working so hard on the body you kind of left the mind behind. And it is corny, but it's true. The more I can't agree more with Ali. The more you work on yourself and your self-confidence, even if the package... to use somebody else's word, even if the package isn't the one you like at the moment, get working on the inside stuff, because it does start to shine through. It absolutely starts to shine through.
No, I don't think I can be happy unless I'm slim.
You know, if you want to have a word with our counsellor, Jackie, and I say that, you probably think, why do I want to talk about weight? 2 reasons, because I know she'll hate me for saying this, but Jackie's just started off working out at my gym as well. So she's, you know, it's never too late to start. Okay.
Yeah, but then I can't afford to go to a gym. I'd love to, but
no,
I can't.
Well, there are other ways to exercise. I was a single mum for 3 years, never went near a gym, but I kept up the exercise. We'll have a chat afterwards.
Okay.
Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you.
Fingers crossed, good luck. And thank you, Ali, for being big and beautiful. You've all been big and beautiful, haven't they?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you all. Take care. All right? See you again soon.